Good morning, Crossing family.
We are so glad to have you here, maybe this weekend after you, gobbled, then you hobbled, trying to burn off some of those calories. Somewhere in there, hopefully you've done what we've done, which is watch a whole lot of Hallmark Christmas movies. I don't know, should I wish that for you? I do, though.
We've prayed a lot, too, about our decisions on the Hallmark movies, because some of them are better than others. We'll leave it at that. Yeah.
Oh, but he ruins them because he always says what's going to happen next.
They're a little predictable. It's not a bad thing. It's something that people look forward to every year. And we also look forward to hanging out and worshiping. So we're excited to have you here this morning and or sometime later in the week. If you're listening and watching later, we're still excited for you to be here as a part of our extended digital family. And, I think we've delighted enough. So have a great morning and, we'll see ya.
Well, good morning. How is everybody? Are you doing okay? Even if you're not doing okay, are you glad to be here at least? Amen. Have you ever been to a Catholic Mass? If you have, there's a lot of stand up, sit down, fight. There's a lot of this going on during that. We're going to do that today. I'm going to play a little. I'm going to preach a little. You're going to stand a little. You're going to sit a little. Is that okay? If it's not, we're still going to do it. So. And if those people are like the 10-minute late people, you're going to miss a lot of this today. We're just glad you're here, though. Online, here in person. Sing with us, yeah?
You've been walking the same old road for miles and miles. You've been hearing the same old voice till the same old lie. You're trying to fill the same old holes inside. There's a better life. You got pain in the painting. You feel lost, he's away, mate. Search for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. We've all run to the things we know just ain't right. There's a better life. You got
Amen, amen. All right, so like I said, Catholic service today, Catholic Mass, stand up, sit down, fight, fight, fight. So now's the time when you can sit down for a second. How's everybody doing? Are you doing all right? Are you hanging in? You showed up, you're under the heaters, unless you're home, and then you're in your stocking feet and your short pants, which is good for you. That's awesome. Pastor Kyle is on vacation, and so if he's watching this right now, turn it off. You're not supposed to be watching this. This counts as work. Watch a different church service. You can't watch the church service on vacation and critique me. Watch it later. So we have been talking about winning in our relationships. We did one on family, friends, marriage. This one is on our relationship with the world. So my question is, how is your relationship with the world? What does it look like? I know it's a little sketchy right now because you're not allowed to go out or do anything, technically. Technically, I don't know. Our county, we live in Yuba County, and they're kind of like, we're not closing this time. And I'm like, I don't know if that's let's see what happens, I guess. So I don't know what they're doing here in Sacramento. Are we closing? They're closing everything? Did they close everything? Sure. Yeah. Pastor Byron said, yeah, kind of did. So your relationship with the world, what does that look like? What is it? And the world doesn't mean, because sometimes we think, oh, man, my relationship with the world, like I need to go unto all the world and go like Haiti or something. But your world consists of across the street. You know that, right? Like your world consists of across the fence from your house. It's the people that live next to you. That's also your world. And so my question is, how's your relationship with the world? Mine is sometimes it's okay. Sometimes it's a little sketchy. Sometimes it's I am an introvert. You guys know that. So sometimes I tend to drive into my garage and shut the door and hide out, and that's just kind of who I am sometimes. So I have to force myself to go out and talk to people. We just got my friend gave us a really nice like home security camera system, and he installs them, and so he came and installed it the other day, and it's on my TV in my bedroom. So there's all the screens, so it's like the Batcave up there. And I was up there the other day with my son. This is my son Joe, by the way, that plays guitar with me and sings. And so we were up there the other day, and he said, hey, I think those people, they're walking their dogs. I think their dogs are going to the bathroom in our yard. And I was like, what? And so it has like a record thing, so I'm rewinding it, and we're doing detective stuff. I'm like, is that dog squatting or not? Because doing a number one in my yard is okay, but not a number two and walking off it. And so I was like, I couldn't tell. So I went outside, and I had it in my head. I was going to go out, and I was going to get, because we have a dog, and I was going to get my little dog bag and pick it up and walk over and knock on their door because I saw where it was. And I was going to go, hey, is this yours? And so in my head, I go out, and I look, and there's nothing. And God goes, hey, remember how you're preaching in a couple days on your relationship with the world? What does your relationship with the world look like if you go over and start knocking on somebody's door and going, is this your bag of dog poop? What kind of a lunatic does that, first off? That's a terrible idea for a pastor and just anybody in general. So thank goodness it wasn't. So my relationship with the world sometimes is touch and go at best. And I'm not going to sit up here and tell you that it's not. I'm not going to be like, oh, my relationship with the world. You don't. I'm a pastor. I have Reverend in front of my name. I don't know if you noticed. I have the paper and everything. Look, nobody cares about that. Look, we're all living this thing together. We're all family, right? We're just a family. So my question is, too, who were you? If you're a Christian now and you're following Jesus, who were you? You think, well, I'm a good person. I'm a pretty decent person. I have some friends that think that just being a good person is going to be good enough. It's good enough. Oh, that's good enough. Just being a good person is good enough. And I'm like, I don't know, because the Bible says in Romans 3, for everyone has sinned. We all fall short of God's glorious standard. All of us. So you think, well, I'm okay. I do all right. And it's like, no, everybody's a mess. And we're all a mess together. And sometimes, like I said, we elevate pastors. Like we elevate even Pastor Kyle. We're like, oh, man, Pastor Kyle's been doing this for a long time. I mean, he planted this church. It's like 19 years. Man, he's something. Trust me, I know him. I really hope he's watching right now. This is why you shouldn't be watching. Look, we're just human. We're just people. And it's okay. It's okay to do life together. It's okay to do those things together, to live together, to be on the road together. Yet God, in his grace, freely makes us right in his sight. He did this through Christ Jesus when he freed us from the penalty of our sins. And my next question is, who are you? Who are you now? Okay, that's who we were. We were all sinners, and we decided if that's what we've decided, we're going to follow Jesus. And who am I now? What do I do now with my life? How do I follow God now? And the Bible is two things. It's super easy, because people are like, man, the Bible's really, really complicated. It's super easy. And everybody's like, wait, I don't think that's right. And it's super hard to follow the super easy part. Because the super easy part is you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, and all your mind. That sounds pretty easy. When you think about it, you're like, oh, man, I just have to love God. I just have to wake up every day and love God and follow God and serve God. And then you wake up and you're like, bleh. I'm tired today, God. And you're just thinking about yourself all day, every day. Look, I don't want you to raise your hands because I don't want to embarrass you, but I'm going to raise my hand. So there are many days where I wake up and the first thing I think about is, ugh, what do I have to do today? What's going on today? The last thing I think about at night, man, that was a long day. What do I have to do tomorrow? And the first thing should be, man, God, what can I do for you today? What do you want me to do today? How can I talk to people about you today? How can I get out in the world today and talk to my neighbors and talk to my friends and talk to my family who don't know you? How can I do that? And we're not great at that. And that's supposed to be the super easy part. This is the first and greatest commandment. A second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand again, but some of you might have a little bit of a sketchy relationship with your neighbors. People park in front of my house sometime. We live in like one of those, you know, the houses are on top of each other and you share a fence kind of a thing. And people park right in front of my house sometimes. And I'm like, how dare you park right? It's street parking. You can park wherever you want. But I'm like, yeah, why would you park in front of my house? Because my relationship sometimes, I'm like, oh, man, it's not about me. And it was Thanksgiving Day, and I'm like, somebody's parked in front of my house. It's Thanksgiving Day. There are 5,000 different cars. It's with the neighbors. Your relationship with your neighbors, your relationship with people, it's difficult. It's hard to wake up sometimes and go, man, I just love my neighbor like I love myself. Because, come on, when you wake up, you think, well, I don't love myself. I'm a terrible human being. Well, come on. You love yourself a little bit. You think about yourself a little bit. We all do. Correct? Love your neighbor as yourself. The entire law and all the demands of the prophets are based on these two commandments. If we could just do those two things, if we could just follow God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength and love our neighbor, how much easier would life be? Like, if you think about it, well, okay, if everybody did that, would there be war? No. If we did that, would there be fist fights in the parking lot at the Walmart on a Black Friday? No. I don't know if that happened this year because of the vid is out, and I think that it messed up Black Friday, but whatever. Did anybody go out for Black Friday? Ooh. Some of you are probably like, I don't want to say that I went out. I don't want to say that I went out and was coughing. And my next question is, who do you want to be? Who do you want to be? Do you want to be somebody who thinks about other people? Do you want to be somebody that is not just about yourself? Do you want to be somebody that really does think about the world and other people? Matthew 18 says, if a man has 100 sheep and one of them wanders away, what will he do? Won't he leave the 99 others on the hills and go out and search for the one that he has lost? And I think about that all the time because people have asked me, they're like, Pastor, what? Why would you leave 99 to go get the one? And I said, well, at present, I have 7 children. If I'm in the store and one of my children wanders off, I don't go, well, I guess they're on their own now. I hope they make it. I hope they're okay. All right, the rest of you 6, let's go home. No! You tell the other 6, hey, stay right here. Don't go anywhere. Hold hands. I got to go find the one that took off. And you know where you find them all the time? In the stupid middle of the clothing rack thing, just hanging out, hiding, and you call the big Amber Alert, and you're like, ah! And they're like, hoof-doo-doo-doo-doo, ding-dong, what are you doing? Don't walk off from the old man. And I feel like that's how God is, too. He's like, ah, I'll be back. But God's not as annoyed as I am as a dad, by the way. God's not like, ugh, these people. He's like, okay, I love this person so much. I love you so much that when you wander off, I'll come and find you. I love you so much. I created you to be something, to do something. I created you. I knew who you were before you were born. I love you so much, I'm going to come and find you. That's the great thing about God. That no matter how far we run from God, I don't care how far you think you ran from God, the second you turn back and go, hey, God, he's right there. It isn't like you don't have to like work your way back or go, oh, man, he's way over there, and I got to get all the way over there now. God is like right here, and it's like, ah. He's like, hey, I've been here the whole time. I've been following you the whole time. I've just been waiting for you to turn around. And that's the great thing about God. That's the great thing about our relationship with the world even, because we're like, man, my relationship with my neighbors is terrible. My relationship with the world is terrible. You can change that today. Today you can make an effort. I don't know. Look, on social media, whatever, I tell people all the time, I'm an old man, so I text and stuff, but a phone call means a lot. Like if I really want to talk to somebody, I'll call them on the phone. Be like, hey, how you doing? I just wanted to hear your voice. I just wanted to see, because some of you have strained relationships with your family and your friends, and I get it. It's difficult, but you can only do what you can do. And so you do the best that you can do. You love God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself to the best of your ability, and then whatever happens past that is on that person. You get that, right? Like, you're not responsible for somebody else. I can't force somebody to come to heaven with me. I can't punch them or scare them into heaven. Yeah, you're all going to die. That never works. We used to do that when younger. Anybody ever been to old-timey church when you were younger? I grew up in an old-timey church and used to get that, like, every other Sunday. Oh, the fires of hell. And you're like, I don't want the fires of hell. The fires of hell are burning down here, by the way, if you're sitting close enough. If you're here in person, we got the fires of hell burning. Yeah, you're welcome, by the way, because y'all, it's cold here. You just want to love people. You want to love people. And if he finds it, I tell you the truth, he will rejoice over it more than the 99 that didn't wander away. How excited is God when you come back? It's like, man. And I don't want you to think that either. I want you to be like, well, God's super excited when I run off and come back, so I'm just going to keep running off and coming back because he'll be excited about it. Look how happy God is. No, God just wants you to spend time with him. In the same way, is it not my heavenly Father's will that even one of these little ones should perish? You're one of the little ones. We're one of the little ones. You think, well, it's little kids. No, it's not little kids. It's you. It's us. It's me. God loves you. God wants to chase after you. God cares for you. God wants you to be something that he's called you to be. Because he loves you so much. Do you believe that? If you don't, I hope you leave here today and I hope you believe that. Searching for you. You're going to feel like I have a great relationship with God. He still just wants you with him. I think I've said this before. I didn't like this song at first because it talks about God kicking down a door to find me. And I'm like, I'm a grown man. I don't need a man kicking down. I don't need God kicking down any doors for me. And I really do. I need God to rescue me. I need God to save me.
For I spoke a word. So good to me. For I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind.
sing this out. Come on. God is always in control. He's just after you. Because he loves you. No shadow you won't light up. Mountain you won't climb up. Coming after me. No wall you won't kick down. Lie you won't tear down. Coming after me. No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. Sing it to him, come on. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Say, how do we do that, Pastor? How do we follow God? How do we give ourselves away? How do we follow Him? How do we love God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength? Well, let me tell you. In Ephesians, it says, put on God's armor so that you will be able to stand firm against all the strategies of the devil. You know that the devil is always against you, right? Like all day, every day. When you're sleeping, he's planning on how to kill you. That, and you're like, oh, man, that sounds like a lot. Yeah, it is a lot. He wants to destroy you. One of my favorite pastors, one of my favorite preachers just had to step down. He got fired because he got caught in an affair over these last 5 months with COVID. Pastor in New York, a guy that I really like to listen to him speak, and I'm like, man. Because if the devil can get you to fall, then he can try to get people around you. Like if he can get you to fall, he can try to get your family. Because you're like, well, they were a Christian, and look at them. That was a big mess. And here's the thing. You will fall sometimes. You will mess up. You will do stupid things. You will say stupid things. If you have children, you know what I'm talking about. If you have one kid, don't talk to me. Fine. I grew up an only child. Don't talk to me about that one kid. When you get more than two, then we can start to have a discussion. When it's more than three, you're hurting cats at that point. But you get it. Sometimes those kids, you're just like, ah, I just want to choke you a little bit. Just a little bit. Just so your eyes bug out just a little bit, and then I'll stop. But you can't do that. But you get it. You understand it. That's why you have to wake up every morning and put on that armor of God and be like, oh, man, this is going to be a fight today. It's going to be a fight today because every day is a fight. Every day is a battle. Look, we as Christians, we have won the war. We're going to win in the end. Yay, us. But we have to fight to get there, and we have to fight to get as many people with us to go to heaven as we can. And that's tough because we wake up every morning, we're like, ah, it's all about me today. It's all about me today. What am I going to get out of church today? Do you ever walk away from church? I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand again because I've done it. Do you ever walk away from church and go, I didn't get anything out of that at all? Well, whose fault's that? That's not my fault. That's not Pastor Kyle's fault. You think what Pastor Kyle preaches, he's like, whatever. I don't care about this week. Who cares about this week? No. You, as a pastor, you're sweating that. Ask Pastor Byron. He's preached a few times. Ask if he sweat it out. You sweat it out, man. Especially when you're first new at it, you're like, whoa, blah, blah. That's all you think about. I think that's how we should be as Christians sometimes. We should be like, man, how? We should be sweating it out. We should be like, man, I just want to love people today. How do I love people today? Can I love somebody? How do I react to this situation better? How can I do this better? How can I do this more godly? For we are not fighting against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world, against mighty powers in this dark world. People are like, the world's okay. Yeah, the world's mostly good. Is it? Because in the verse before, it said, for all have sinned. All of us. It's all a mess. We're fighting against this. We're fighting against evil spirits in heavenly places. Look, there's stuff going on you can't even see. There's stuff going on you don't know about. That's why you got to keep praying. That's why you got to keep just following Jesus. That's why you got to wake up every morning and put that armor on and think, man, how can I love my neighbor? How can I love God today? How can I love people today? Because if you don't make that conscious effort to do that, you won't do it. Because, come on, I mean, really, left to our own devices, we're kind of knuckleheads. I mean, you know, and some people are like, I'm not a knucklehead. I follow you. I do. No, come on. Come on. If I followed you around 24/7 with my super secret security video cameras like I got now, come on. I was watching myself on like the reverse of my thing, and I'm like, ugh, man. That's why I told the family, I was like, you got to be careful what you do now. And it's not in like weird places like the bedrooms, it's all out in the common areas, but I'm like, you can't be smacking kids now. It's all on video. No, we don't do that. We don't do that. And don't think I'm making light of that. I'm not. I don't think I've ever smacked my kids once. Have I ever smacked you? We had to think about it, though. He's like, let me think. were a couple times. You just choked me till my eyes bugged out a little bit, but I don't think you ever smacked me. God wants you to stand up for him so you can make a difference in people's lives, yeah? Tell people about him. He's making a stand for you. You make a stand for him. Amen?
You stood before creation, eternity in your hand. You spoke the earth into motion, my soul now to stand. You stood before my face, carried the cross for my shame. My sin weighed upon your soul, my soul now to stand. So what can I say? What can I do? So I walk upon salvation, Spirit alive in me. This life to declare your promise, my soul now is dead. So what can I say?
Sing with you. Lungs up and your hands up. Yeah. God is good. Come on.
So I stand with arms high and heart abandoned in awe of the one who gave it all. I'll stand. Surrendered all I am is yours. So I stand with arms high and heart abandoned in awe of the one who gave it all. I'll stand my soul, Lord, to you surrendered all. There is no one higher, no one greater, no one like our God.
says, so when the apostles were with Jesus, they kept asking him, Lord, has the time come for you to free Israel and restore our kingdom? I like that the apostles are still asking, look, God, when are you going to fix our immediate problems? He replied, the Father alone has the authority to set those dates and times, and they're not for you to know. It's none of your business. You read books on, well, Revelation says, God's coming back, and this is definitely the last generation. I've been hearing that since I was a little kid. This is probably the last decade we're going to be, and yet here we are. Who cares when he's going to come back? Act like it's 2 seconds from now. Act like it's 2 million years from now. We want as many people to go with us as we can. That's why God's waiting. He's waiting on us. He's waiting on people. Thank you, God, for that. What if Jesus decided to come back the day before you accepted him into your life? Yeah. So if you're like, man, God, why won't you come back? That's why. Because he loves the world, and he wants you to love the world. After saying this, he was taken up into a cloud while they were standing there watching, and they could no longer see him. As they strained to see him rising into heaven, 2 white-robed men suddenly stood among them. Men of Galilee, they said, why are you standing here staring into heaven? Jesus has been taken from you into heaven, but someday he will return from heaven in the same way you saw him go. So they're basically saying, look, stop standing around. Go do something. Get out in the world. Get out into your neighborhood. Talk to people. Even if you have to yell at them across the street because you're not allowed to because of COVID, you can yell across the street. God said go. That includes going into your family. Yeah. Your neighborhood, your city, your state, your country, the world. Relationship with the world look like? God is concerned about that because he loves people. God wants you to stand firm, but God wants you to stop standing around. Amen. Amen. Today, we just want to be yours. We just want to make a stand for you, God, the way you stand for us. We just want to search for that one the way you search for us when we're lost, God. God, be with our relationships. Help us to focus on you when we wake up, when we go to sleep, all throughout the day. Let it be about you. Help us to love you with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. And God, love our neighbors like we do ourselves. God, forgive us when we don't do that. Break our hearts for people, Father. Break our hearts for this world, for the lost, for the weary. We just need more of you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Your name. Amen. Thanks for hanging out with us today. So glad you're here. So glad you tuned in online. unless you're Pastor Kyle, and shame. Have a great week. I challenge you to love somebody today. Amen. Have a good day.